Let's look at three examples of AI integration into existing app and SaaS. What kind of software? How did AI make it way better? And how can you benefit from all this? Keep watching. In this video, we're going to take a look at how three big software companies are using generative AI to drastically improve their user experience. We'll look at how companies are using text, video, and audio-based generative AI to add new features and turn an already good product into a great product. No bad products allowed. Sorry, Homelander.
You are simply bad product.
So this video is mainly for those who already have an app or SaaS that's generating revenue, maybe even profitable. What can you take away from how these big guys use AI and apply that to your puny insignificant apps? Kidding, it's not insignificant, but it probably is puny. Let's get to the list. We're kicking off with one of the most widely used, probably the most widely used graphic design tool, Canva Magic Studio. But there's a plot twist. It's not real magic. It's just AI. I know this because I'm very active in the magician community and we've never seen them around. It's a bit dishonest, but since it's a great product on behalf of magicians everywhere, it will allow Canva Magic Studio to keep the name. The Magic Studio applies generative AI help to every type of content generation feature Canva already has. Instead of having to manually search for the right template, you can just describe what you want and the AI does the searching for you and with some minor customization. The AI isn't actually generating anything truly new here, it's just accessing Canva's huge library of templates. Their Magic Studio also simplifies the process of repurposing content. So if you have a design you like, you can automatically change it to a slightly different format, to a different dimension, and to different languages. And for times where Pixels and Unsplash doesn't have the photo you need and you're too broke to pay for a photo license, Canva lets you generate an image directly on the platform and drag it into your design. And let's say you do have a Pixel photo that's usable, almost, just need a bit of editing. Magic Studio has a ton of very powerful and easy to use editing features with image expanding, background removing, random shit adding, and whatever the hell you call this, but it's awesome. And it's not just for static pictures. You can generate videos and integrate them into designs too. I'm not personally a big fan of them, but if it matches your brand or product, you can also create talking head videos with what looks like rejected Overwatch characters. And people kind of take AI text generation for granted nowadays. I think that just shows how spoiled we are. Just because it's common doesn't mean it's not worth highlighting. Yes, Canva lets users generate copy automatically with AI. You can set your brand voice and summarize or expand on points as needed very easily. But any designer will tell you that the text is part of design, not just content. So how it looks is almost as important as what it says. And Canva has an AI feature that addresses this called Magic Morph. It applies to shape as well, but text is where I see the most valuable application. So basically, you can just write what you need to write and tell the AI to change the way the font looks, and it does that for you. You can do this manually with Canva. Canva has tons of fonts and effects you can play with. But if you already know the look you're going for and you don't feel like browsing randomly, just tell the AI what you want and it does the browsing for you and gives you what you might have scrolled past by mistake. You know how there are movies where a caveman is frozen in ice and the ice melts and the caveman experiences the modern world? I wonder what graphic designers in the 90s and 2000s would feel like if they spent a week on a design and then a kid just hits a button on Canva and destroys them. The thought of people realizing how replaceable they are always fills me with joy. And you know what else fills me with joy?
My mom!
Well, that and also helping you grow your business. My team and I at Upside Studio help non-technical entrepreneurs grow past $5 to $10 million in annual revenue with custom software. We've worked with over 30 leading brands across industries. These businesses were stuck where no ready-made solution on the market solved their problem. To continue growing, they had to make their own solution. If your business is also currently stuck at this $5 to $10 million level and you want to explore custom solutions, let me help. There's a link in the description to sign up for a free, no strings attached strategy session. We'll dissect your current constraint together and you get an honest opinion about whether custom software is your answer. And if yes, we decide if we can work together. If it's not, you just save yourself from a very big investment with no ROI. Apply through the link and we'll be in touch. I'm only taking 3 of these calls per month and it's first come, first serve. So if you want to work with me, apply now. Back to the video. I was a bit torn between 2 very similar options for my second mention, but I decided to go with ClickUp Brain. The other one I considered was Asana Intelligence, but it seems to be still in beta, so ClickUp won. And what's up with all these companies giving their spin on AI a fancy name? Canva Magic. ClickUp Brain. There's no brain, it's just AI. Don't you know how dangerous real brains are? They have lasers.
Hey, brain! Wait, stop! Don't shoot!
But anyway, ClickUp is one of the world's leading work, project, and task management tools used by solopreneurs all the way to giant enterprises to manage a project, work, and task. And ClickUp has taken a role-based approach to how they incorporate AI. You have 3 roles powered by AI: knowledge manager, project manager, and writer. The AI has access to your documents, your pending task, your teammates, their pending task, everything. So it really becomes a wise old librarian who knows where all the books are. What can you do with a wise old librarian in ClickUp? You can automatically create tasks and subtasks complete with descriptions, which is probably the most time-consuming task to do manually. Summarize documents and get a list of progress updates within a certain time frame and find out who made those changes. Automate daily signups to save a huge amount of time in the long run. I would use this for my team, but they already fear me as they should. And communicate with audio or video messages without making your teammates hate you, since the messages are all auto-transcribed by AI. The whole point of tools like ClickUp is to simplify the amount of work doing non-work tasks. And AI is like the perfect complement to that. What employee would ever say no to more time for slacking off? And now the last and best example, Grammarly AI.
Adrian, are you seriously mentioning a writing tool?
That's like the most boring and generic way to use AI. I agree, and that's exactly why I chose Grammarly. You would think that in a world with ChatGPT, Grammarly wouldn't exist. Like how smartphones destroyed Nokia, or how Netflix destroyed Blockbuster. But no, ChatGPT was released into the wild in 2022. In 2022, Grammarly made $89 million in revenue. In 2023, a year after the world embraced the shit out of ChatGPT, Grammarly hits 125 million, growing over 20%. Part of that was probably due to layoffs, but tech companies fire people every year. So let's see how Grammarly incorporates AI into their products. First up, they have something called Grammarly Go, which is where Grammarly integrates with your email, Slack, Skype, Google Docs, and basically any text box online. You can now use Grammarly AI to generate messages with a certain tone: friendly, firm, sympathetic. Not sure if they have evil. This is useful for individuals, but very useful for teams in big companies that need to collaborate and maintain a consistent tone across the board. Grammarly AI will learn the team or company's style guide, and then all employees and team members can rely on it to keep them in check. The tiny things that add up. They can also rely on it to do all the work for them. Why waste time writing an email when Grammarly can now write your entire draft and you just proofread it? And it can suggest changes to emails to improve clarity. And in all this, Grammarly assures clients that their information is kept confidential and won't be used to train other AI models or sold to telemarketers. Meanwhile, let's see how OpenAI handles trust and ethics.
What data was used to train Sora?
We used publicly available data and licensed data.
So, videos on YouTube?
And corporate emails are always a pain. You can spend way too much time trying to align a message with your company's brand when you could be working. And that's putting aside the grammar issues, which can also take up way too much time. Yeah, so I can't really see Grammarly's corporate clients changing over to ChatGPT for their corporate communications anytime soon. One last thing, Grammarly has this really, I don't mean this in a bad way, but it's cute. A cute little page. Basically, they've got a bunch of AI writing tools that seem to be prompted to do specific types of writing. It's not part of the core Grammarly product. I think they're just lead magnets, honestly. But worth mentioning. So based on our three examples, what makes AI integration successful? Three things. It makes it way easier to use a piece of software. This can be by handling the analyzing and summarizing of large amounts of data to make recommendations. That's most AI assistants. Or AI can help by lowering the skill ceiling needed to fully benefit from the software. Like with Canva's Magic Studio, allowing users to easily get the right templates and font styles. Number two, it reduces the risk of human error. Machines are generally better than humans at repetitive tasks. They don't lose focus and they don't get bored. So say you have a process that needs to be done frequently and it has a large potential downstream effect, like hiring a CEO. Using AI to help gives users the assurance that final decisions made are not based on incorrect assumptions and information, like with Grammarly forcing the company style guide down everyone's throat. Number three, it allows users to get the in-app work done faster. A lot of apps make manual tasks digital so they go faster. AI makes digital tasks automatic so they go even faster. Say your business needs to post a holiday greeting on social media, or you need to send a progress email to a client, or you need to know who made a certain change to a code base last Monday. It's not a core function of your business, but it needs to get done. This person doesn't want to waste lots of time doing it. So if AI can do most of it for them at the press of a button, why would they not go for it? Actually, this applies to a lot of social media stuff for businesses. Content creation and scheduling is a necessary evil. So anything that can speed it up and save brain power is appreciated. So as you consider where and how to integrate AI into your products, consider how it can make life easier for a user, reduce the chance of mistakes, and automate low-level tasks. And of course, this can only work if the underlying solution is already validated. AI won't make a shit solution good, but it can make a good solution great. If you already have an idea where you want to integrate AI, check out my tutorial on how to build apps with OpenAI, where I show a simple, non-tech founder-friendly way to do it. If you enjoyed this video, please leave a like and subscribe for more supplies. Cheers, guys!